Computer will not turn on, but fans are running. Here are four ways you can fix it. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Now, let's get started. Method 1. The first thing you need to check is the power source. The power from the wall outlet can be fluctuating. First, try connecting to a different power outlet. If the issue persists, check the PSU. A good power supply unit is important for the proper functioning of the hardware components. Open PC casing and check whether the PSU is connected properly with the hardware components. If possible, you can remove the PSU and plug it in another PC to check if it is working correctly. Method 2. RAM is quite significant for booting a PC. If the motherboard doesn't recognize the RAM, whether the RAM slot or the RAM itself may be malfunctioning. One common mistake many make is not seating the RAM properly. Seating a RAM properly requires quite some force, which many novices fear will break the motherboard. However, don't try seating the RAM with all your strength. Simply make sure that it is done correctly. Reseat the RAM and check if the PC starts. If it doesn't, then seat the RAM in other slots and then check. Also, while you are at it, clean the RAM slot and the RAM itself with a dry, lint-free cloth. Simple dust can be behind many hardware issues, including preventing the RAM from getting recognized. Now, if all this is done and still the PC won't boot but fans full speed running, the RAM stick can be faulty or unsupported. If you have recently purchased the RAM stick, have you made sure to buy one that your motherboard supports? Make sure you have purchased the correct RAM. Method 3. If both the RAM and the power supply is not causing this issue, the PC can be incorrectly configured. If you are building a new PC or changing your old hardware components, it is possible that all the connections are not done properly. In such circumstances, unplugging everything and putting them back together is the correct course of action. First, identify all the different cables attached to your case. This will be labeled as HDD, LED, power switch, reset switch, etc. Find the front panel of your motherboard. Open the motherboard diagram in your motherboard manual. It will be different for different companies, but it should look like this image. Plug in the following computer connections on the motherboard's front panel by using the motherboard diagram from the manual as a guide. Reset. This connection is for the reset button on the case. Power. This is the LED connection on the front panel. It is also called message. Power switch. This connection is for the power button on the case. HDD. LED. This is the hard drive activity light. This light will blink or turn on when the hard drive is working. Speak. This is the connection for the speaker on the inside of the case. Next, find the case fan's connector and locate the label that says sys_fan and connect them. If there are small memory fans with 3-pin connectors, look for sys_fan or sys_fan2 and plug in the connectors. Once you connected the case fans, it's time to connect the CPU fan. Look for labels on the motherboard as CPU fan and plug it in there. Connect the 24-pin PSU motherboard connector and then connect the 8-pin CPU or motherboard cable. Seat the RAMs and connect the HDD or SSD. Seat the graphics card in the PCI slot and connect the 6 or 8 pin PCI power cable with the SMPS. Put together the rest of the PC and check if the issue persists. Method 4. If putting everything back together doesn't make the PC start, the motherboard is likely malfunctioning. At this stage, you should take your PC to a service center and let them have a look. Even if it is not the motherboard, other PC components are definitely damaged. Which is why computer fans turn on but nothing shows else. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and always remember that we are here to help you out.